future generations of LPAA clinicians and scholars. And thanks to Jen Lehman for taking notes for our group. One really interesting focal point was that LPAA represents an approach that we should have across all areas of challenge and disabilities, not just aphasia. And that if our students from the very start were to learn about that, and then start very early and have repeated exposure to the WHO ICF in the context of any kind of challenge that they might be studying about would be helpful. And that we give students early on and repeated exposure to people with aphasia. So bring the people with aphasia to the classroom, and there were a few really interesting examples. One of having an aphasia panel, interviewing caregivers in class, having small groups work on assessment in the same time in the same classroom and processing that together, using video where it's a very interactive experience. So instead of just playing through a whole video, stopping repeatedly to analyze what's going on and make it not just observing that video, but really talking and processing through, maybe good and bad examples of that people could be observing. Let me see. How do we get it into our curriculum? How do we get our academic instructors to bridge with LPAA content to clinical supervisors? How do we ensure that clinical supervisors are on board? So for a lot of us, we have separate roles of clinical supervision versus the academic instructors. And can we do more to bridge any philosophy there and the manner in which we talk about LPAA? And that leads to co-writing and reiterating what was already said, that make sure that we're working with students on goal writing from an early start to think about that big life picture piece. Some resources, Jerry Hefner has some amazing examples of the ways he integrates students into service learning experiences with people with aphasia and aphasia groups. There's some great resources through Katarina Haley's website. We talked about how we might as a group be more contributory through our own, through Aphasia Access and National Aphasia Association. Maybe there are ways we could share more in terms of resources, videos. Simucase is one thing that we talked about, that maybe we could enhance some of the case availability through Simucase that would be more LPAA focused. Same with Master Clinician, these resources that people are using with increasing frequency. We talked about how there are some such amazing examples on YouTube and how it's also a pain to sort through all the stuff that's not so good. And, let's put in a plug for not having your students post everything on. regardless of quality, because it does mock up the search for really important